Welcome to the Good News Radio broadcast. Hello, this is Brenda Harris greeting you in the precious name of Jesus. Before Jesus, every knee will bow and every tongue will confess that Jesus is Lord. Marlena had cerebral palsy, an injury to the brain that disrupts motor function. I watched her testimony on Sid Roth's It's Supernatural. She had come to a very desperate situation in her life. They had prayed and prayed for her healing, but it didn't come. What struck me the most about this testimony is that finally Marlena told God, "Just leave." While she was being interviewed, she began crying when the interviewer asked her, "What did Jesus do when you told him to leave?" Marlena said, "He wouldn't leave." At that point, I began crying myself at the thought of God having so much love that he wouldn't leave. If someone told you to leave, would you leave? If someone told me to leave, I think I would leave. I guess it would be according to who it was and what the situation was, but I am so very happy that we have a God that won't always leave if we tell him to. Marlena was so unhappy because she had not received her healing. She was getting very impatient about not getting her healing. But instead of God leaving when she told him to leave, he gave her a vision. In this vision, she saw a preacher laying hands on her head and praying for her. They looked all through the churches in the phone book. They called this particular church and asked if they believed in divine healing. The preacher said, "Yes." Marlena said, "You can come see me." Marlena was in the hospital. The preacher came to see her, and on Sunday, they took Marlena to church. The preacher said that no one had ever been healed in that church before. He laid hands on her head and prayed. Then he asked Marlena if she would like to take a step of faith. They lifted her up, and she took one step, and then another, and then another. With each step, her motor function got better. Pretty soon she was running around the church and praising God. She was totally healed. What a mighty miracle. Now that's what happens when God won't leave. God can be pretty stubborn. Aren't you glad? God is persistent. You may very well wonder why God didn't answer her prayer many years before that. That reminds me of the story in the Bible of a blind man who was born that way. He received his sight from Jesus later on in his life. The disciples asked Jesus if the man's blindness was because of the sins of his parents. Jesus said, "No, this happened to bring glory to God," Jesus said. Marlena's story is similar to that, I think. God showed his glory through the healing of Marlena later on in her life. The Bible tells us that God will never leave you nor forsake you. Sometimes you may feel that he is far away. And when I feel that way, I just pray to God, and then I read his Bible, and pretty soon I feel his mighty presence. How comforting and reassuring that is. I remember the story of a man who said that his wife was a Christian. He went to church with her just to make her happy, but the man was not a Christian. God dealt with him to give his heart and life to God many times. The man became very impatient. He told God, "Leave me alone." Immediately, God's presence left the man. The man said he could feel the difference right away. The man became very, very frightened. The Bible tells us to accept God while he is near, while he may be found. God deals with people all of the time. His grace is being shown to them. His grace is being extended. But if they repeatedly reject God, or if they trample the Son of God underfoot repeatedly, God's presence can be removed permanently. This man who told God to leave called the pastor and told the pastor what happened. The pastor told the man to go to church and continue to pray. The man did just that, and a year later, while they were singing Amazing Grace in church, the man jumped up and said, "He's back! He's back!" I can feel him. He got right with God. If you are on the fence about accepting God, don't play around with that. The Bible tells us that it's a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living God. God is the one who made us and not we ourselves. Don't treat God like an old shoe to be cast aside at your whim. It is a great honor to receive an invitation from the Almighty who created heaven and earth. God is worthy of great glory, honor, and respect. We will all bow at the feet of Jesus at one time or another. Just make sure that it's during your lifetime before you die. Pray with me today. Today is the day of salvation. Say, Jesus, I accept you into my heart and life. Change me for your glory, O God. I will serve you and thank you that you wouldn't leave. And now, this concludes the message today. Again, this is Brenda Harris blessing you in Christ's name. May God's face shine upon you and show you his great favor.